Okie dokie, focus. This is Beta 2 of Elite Dangerous. It came out on September the 30th, just over a week ago. I've been meaning to come back to this after doing the Premium Beta video, but Standard Beta 1 wasn't exactly that much different to the Premium Beta, save from a few more star systems and a couple more ships. But this one is a significant improvement. As you can tell, the graphics are a hell of a lot prettier, and the frame rate is startlingly good. Even on this PC, which is a Generation 2 i5 with a GTX 570 video card. I mean, it's not quite a constant 60 frames per second, but I mean, it's getting up there. Admittedly, I do have VSync turned off to do that, and Fraps does tend to crap out when it sees torn frames, so if you see any stutters, that's the reason why. Now check this out. When I first saw this, I thought that the space station had loaded in and rendered correctly, but it turns out that we are on one of the new outposts from Beta 2, which are very exposed, simple docking platforms in space. This one obviously being on the dark side of a planet and everything. Now, I'm not going to get into the trading and the combat because it's pretty much the same. There's an awful lot of new menus, but I don't think I'm going to get very deep into that today. I just want to go for a little pleasure flight. In fact, I want to fly past this planet and see an awesome sunrise. Now, to do that without taking roughly about 10 hours, I have to get out of mass lock, which means flying away from the outpost a bit, and then I can go into super cruise and we can fly around the planet. Now should go off in a minute. I've got a boost out. There we go. I think it's gone now. Let's press super cruise and find. Oh bloody hell, I've got my landing gear up, idiot. Right, there we go. Right, now I should be able to do it, he says. There we go. Charging up Super Cruise now. 3, 2, 1, and there we go. Now, the problem for me currently is Super Cruise mode doesn't seem to be as seamlessly integrated as it could be with regular spaceflight mode at the moment. There are certain aspects of the game that are not loaded in when you're in Super Cruise, such as space stations and other ships and stuff like that, because I guess you're flying at such a speed you wouldn't expect to fly past them and notice them. However, it does feel a little bit jarring when you drop out and all of a sudden something appears right in front of you, which I'm sure you'll see soon enough. If we go somewhere else after this. Oh, check that out. Doesn't that look awesome? Look at it. That's pretty. That's space porn. Elite Dangerous is nothing if it isn't space porn, I'm telling you. Check that out. Now, all of these planets are procedurally generated. And eventually, in later expansions, we're going to be able to fly down and land on them, which is going to be pretty cool. Especially if we can get out of the ship as well, which is another expansion that's planned. Luckily, I backed it to such a level that I got all those expansions for free when they finally come out. Now, what you see out at the front there, that's a bone of contention in the forums at the moment. People are saying that the Milky Way shouldn't be anywhere near that bright in the sky when you're flying around in space. But it's still pretty. I'm sorry, it is still pretty. It actually dims depending on how much light pollution is around you at the time, which is pretty cool as well. Anyway, let's look at the galaxy map and find us somewhere to fly. The galaxy map has been improved a little bit as well. We can fly to 500 systems now in Beta 2. Obviously, you're limited by your hyperdrive range and your fuel, but I think we're going to go to Dahan. That was where we took off from in my Premium Beta video. Let's go back to where it all began. Oh yes. Righty-ho, let's align our destination star system and begin the hyperdrive countdown. There we go, start that off. For some reason, the target radar is now on the left of the main radar display, not the right. No idea why, whatever floats Frontier's boat, I guess. Oh well, almost charged. 4, 3, 2, 1. Punch it, Chusen. This hyperspace effect is still a little bit stuttery. Was in the first two betas as well. It's a shame considering how smooth it is in the rest of the game now. Oh well. And here we have the star, Dehan, Dehan, whatever it is pronounced. Right, I've got to find my target. Right, Dehan Gateway, there we go. That was the space station we flew out of originally. Orbiting the planet Hathor, a gas giant with rings. You might remember that we went to see the ring system there. Well, we didn't go into the ring system so much as skim it a little bit and then fly off. But I think what we should do is go back to the planet Hathor before we go to the space station. You see, in Beta 2, Frontier's procedural generation system for the planets and star systems, called Stellar Forge, I believe, has received a significant upgrade. And because of that, ring systems and asteroid fields now fall into various different categories, metal, ice and rock. So it'll be interesting to see exactly what the rings of Hathor now look like, because when we first went there, they were just a bunch of brown rock. So with these new rock types, along with some particle effects to simulate dust and the like, it should be a far more impressive sight. Now, I've already seen one of these asteroid fields in motion when I was at EGX. When I donned the Oculus Rift and realised that I'm probably going to be spending the rest of my life living in this game when I get one. The demo that they showed was a combat scene inside an ice asteroid field, and it really, really was quite impressive. So I await to see exactly how well this particular rig does at rendering a whole shitload of space rock. Now, it's pretty obvious at first glance that Hathor has changed quite significantly. Not only is the planet's surface a hell of a lot lighter, the rings are white instead of brown now, and have various densities. So I'm guessing that this is an ice ring system. So let's see how close we can get down to seeing this. Oh, look at that planet, that's pretty cool. Right, let's get down here. Let's get... Oh, they're starting to appear. They're starting to become visible. I think I'm going to have to slow down a fair bit to see this properly. Okay, let's get down a little bit further. Oh, we can see them now. This is interesting. Let's go inside. Let's go inside and actually navigate our way around it. Let's drop down a little bit further. There we go. Going in too close. Ugh. I really hate the dropout of Super Cruise, especially in situations such as this. You can tell the jarring dissimilarities between Super Cruise space and normal space there. But wow. This is very, very similar to the combat demo that they showed at EGX, actually. Very similar. Wow, look at that. That is amazing. And do you know what? The frames per second currently aren't that far off 60, even on this rig. It's dropping down to the mid-50s every so often, but, really? I'm quite surprised. I'm quite impressed that it's managing to hold up as well as it is. Kudos to Frontier for optimising their system so well, because that's a lot of rock. That's a lot of graphics it's shifting right there, isn't it? I mean, you can see some level of detail pop in every so often. I'm not going to deny that. But yet again, Mr. Braben, OBE and co. have delivered me some lovely, lovely space porn. Ah. Fap, fap, fap. Alrighty then, I guess I should start turning towards the station and getting myself out of this mess. I mean, I've been told that the odds of navigating something like this are 30,000 to 1, but the way I see it, it doesn't seem that hard. Though saying that, I am driving particularly slowly. There's Dahan Gateway out in the distance there, we can see it. I've got to fly out of the field before I can actually go into Super Cruise though. Look at that, it is, it's wonderful, it's marvellous. I like it a lot. And this is only Beta 2, you've got to remember. It can only get better from here. Beta 3 is going to get released at the end of the month, as far as I'm aware. I don't know if there'll be that much of a leap in improvement as there was between 1 and 2, because the distance between releases is a bit shorter. But still, everything Elite Dangerous has done up to this point has really, really impressed me. And in comparison, Star Citizen seems like it's slacking. They seem to be more interested in selling premium fucking spaceships. With the amount of money in their coffers to fund development compared to this game, I would have expected far, far more from Star Citizen by now. I really would. But I'll shut up about that. Because I don't want to come off as an Elite fanboy, despite the fact that, yeah, I am an Elite fanboy. I grew up in the 1980s. In the UK. This is part of our gamer heritage. Of course I'm a fanboy of Elite. I mean, I'm a big arcade game fan. Everybody knows that. I'm an arcade gamer. But when it comes to home computer games, this is the one that started it all off. Anyway, we're off on Super Cruise now. Let's get to the fucking space station and get this over and done with. We've dragged this flight on long enough, I think. How far have we got to go? 1.8 light seconds and counting. We'll speed up slowly but surely. Let's just get to this space station, dock, and then we can all go and have our tea. When we get to this space station, you will see what I was talking about regarding dropping out of Super Cruise, because what will happen is the space station will literally appear to you out of nowhere, and it's slightly immersion breaking. I mean, it's not a big issue, but it's a shame that there isn't some kind of zoom in effect like you get when you come out of hyperspace and the star kind of zooms towards you. I'm not sure if it'd be easy for Frontier to implement that in this circumstance the same way as it works when you drop out of hyperspace, but it'd be a neat way to show that you slowed down. What the hell is that? Is that a hyperspace cloud? A comet? No idea. Oh well, safe disengage ready. Let's drop out and watch the space station magically appear in front of us. When you're ready. It's taking a while. Come on. Hello. Alright, there we go. And yeah, there we go. Plop. Right in front of you. Dropped out closer than usual as well. And facing the front of it, which is useful. Anyway, let's get our docking clearance. Contacts. There we go. Request docking. Thank you very much, and let us fly in. I'm getting kind of good at this now. I'm going to screw it up now I've said that, aren't I? The curse of one credit champ strikes again. This is going to be easy enough. Done it enough times now. In far bigger ships than this bloody Sidewinder, I'm telling you. We're going in at a bit of a wonky angle. There we go, docking bay 21. Slow down a bit here. Casually glide ourselves in. Frame rate has noticeably taken a hit now I'm in this space station. We're on the low 50s. This is the only time that it's really, really dropped that low. Certainly no deal breaker for me though, although I will probably be upgrading my PC before final release. There we go, landed on the pad. Look at the big old station. Yeah. Pretty. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Very nice looking game. I hope you agree. I think all that needs to be done now is for us to stow our ship away in the hangar, get out for a while, stretch our legs, go to the canteen, and go and get ourselves our space tea. Down, down, deeper and down, as the quo once said. Yeah, And just think, when the other expansions come out, we will be able to step outside our ship and possibly go to the canteen and have our space tea. But for now, I'm just going to step out of my chair and go into the kitchen and have some non-space tea. Yeah. Oh, well. Until next time, cheerio, have a good one, and whatever you do, don't eat all the space biscuits.